This is Margaret from the blog Don't Call It Bollywood, and this is this week's box office post, which is kind of the sum up for all of Tiger Zinda Hei's box office. Because this week there is a clear, steady decline in Tiger Zinda Hei box office, which means we're probably nearing the end of its run, at least the significant portion of its run. There'll probably be maybe another million that's collected globally, but overall it's almost finished. Which means now is a time to look at it and see where it lines up with other hits. Now, first, I should say, I'm going to completely ignore the India numbers, as I almost always do. This isn't because I don't care about India. This is just because the India box office figures are not really reliable, so I don't want to spend a lot of time going into them or analyzing or discussing them when we don't actually know how true they are. The global box office figures are collected by a company called RentTrack that is extremely reliable and extremely careful and precise in how they collect figures. So those are the ones I'm going to focus on. Right now, Tiger Zinda Hei is doing about 17, 18 million globally, which is a lot of money. I'm not going to say it isn't a lot of money, but let's look at what we're comparing it with. PK did 41 million globally, and that was a couple of years ago. Inflation is consistent, which means every year money has less value, which means the overall total numbers, 41 versus 17, don't quite mean the same thing. It should be easier for a movie to make more money now because money has less value, so more money has less actual financial value than it used to, than it did a few years ago, which means even just with basic inflation, you should expect to see an increase in box office revenue. Now, PK was an extremely successful film, so I'm not going to say that Tiger should necessarily be the same as PK, but it should be a marked increase from other similar films in earlier years. So I took a look at the top 10 box office hits for all time globally for Indian film. At the top is Dangal, which was last year. And that's good. That's how it should be. The most recent film should be at the top of the list, or at least one of the more recent films should be at the top of the list because of inflation and because of progress moving forward. Also, especially globally, Indian film is constantly increasing the number of screens and the markets it is reaching. So with those two combinations, there should be a steady move forward. And mostly for the past, 9 years since Three Idiots, there has been that steady move forward. The way it works is a film like Three Idiots makes a sudden jump into a whole new level. And then there's a lag period, a few years while films scramble to catch up to it. There's sort of the peak movie at the very top, and then a bunch of plateau movies down below. Most recently, the peak movie was, oh, now I'm blanking. The Three Idiots, and then Dangal, and then PK, and then what was the one right before PK? It was another Aamir Khan. Doom 3. Most recently, Doom 3 was the highest one. It was at 31,000. And then there was a bunch of other movies that came between, say, 31 million, that came between 23 million and 31 million, and they all sort of clustered and slowly reached that plateau. Now what should be happening, Dangal has made another huge leap forward. We should be seeing an increasing number of movies that are reaching the PK plateau, around 41 million. Movies should be getting closer and closer to that until finally one of them tops PK, and then finally one of them will top Dangal. Instead, we're seeing this massive slide back. I'll give you the actual numbers. In 2009, Three Idiots came out and changed everything in terms of the Indian box office. I cannot overemphasize what a big deal Three Idiots was. I remember when it came out and how exciting it was. People saying, this is just like a whole new box office all of a sudden, a whole new level of profits. And that was true both globally and locally. What was a little different was what happened in 2010. On Valentine's Day 2010, just a few months after Three Idiots at Christmas, My Name is Khan came out and almost toppled Three Idiots' global record. Locally, it wasn't that big of a deal, partly because of the protests, but also more generally, Shah Rukh Khan, Kajol romance just wasn't the blockbuster in India that it was for the rest of the world. But in the rest of the world, My Name is Khan almost toppled the Three Idiots record just 3 months later. And here's an important thing to know, it toppled it on Valentine's Day. Most of these top 10 films on the list, I think it's something like 8 out of the 10 of them were released on Christmas. Actually, no, 6 out of 10 were released on Christmas. 2 more were released on Eid, and then there's 2 others that were not released on an international holiday. Christmas is a big deal, not because of the religious reasons, but just because in almost every place in the world, you get a day off work and a day off school. So if you're talking global figures, Christmas is where it's at. The runner-up would, of course, be Eid for those same reasons. Almost everywhere in the world, you get a day off work and a day off school. So it's great for movies. My Name is Khan was a Valentine's Day release, which is kind of an international holiday, but you don't get a day off for it. And not every country celebrates it as much as Christmas is celebrated by every country. So it's remarkable that this movie almost beat Three Idiots just a few months later, and I want to give it credit and put those two at the level they should have. And then, for a long time, for 5 long years, these were the two record holders. Meanwhile, there are a bunch of films right below them, chugging their way up. The lowest film on the list currently is Chennai Express, which was about 17 million and came out 3 years after My Name is Khan and Three Idiots. And there are a bunch of movies around that level. Chennai Express is the only one left on the list. The other ones have dropped below. But at one point, there was a nice little cluster of films right around the 15,000 to 19, or sorry, 15 million to 19 million range that were all trying to reach the Three Idiots, My Name is Khan level. And then eventually one of them did. In 2015, finally, something jumped up to a new level, and I believe that was Doom 3, which suddenly toppled Three Idiots. And then we have another period where suddenly everything is reaching up to that new level. We have, now I'm trying to think. We have Doom 3, we have Sultan, we have Dilwale, we have a whole bunch of movies that reach there. And that's good. That's what's supposed to be happening. There's a new level, there's a new group that's moving up. But here's where things get different. So we've got the Chennai Express bottom level, and then we've got Three Idiots and My Name is Khan still holding firm in the bottom third. And then we've got this big burst right around 25 million to 31 million, sort of clustered around Doom 3, a bunch of movies that came out around Doom 3. And then above that, we've got PK, and above that, we've got Dangal. But there's a couple of movies that are bucking the trend, and unfortunately, they are the most recent films. Sultan and Tiger Zindahay do not fit this pattern. They're not slowly moving up to the top plateau. They're dropping way down. We're essentially moving backwards in time to 2009. Tiger Zindahay barely made more money than Chennai Express, which means it made less money than Three Idiots and My Name is Khan in the global market. It's still playing, yes, but at the rate it's going, it's doubtful that it will be able to beat My Name is Khan by the end of its run, which means it's going to stay at the very bottom of the list. Sultan, meanwhile, finished its run and did slightly better than that, but it's still clustered in the group around the 2013 films, around Doom 3 and some others. It's still a far step backwards from where PK reached, and nowhere even close to where Dangal is now. The way things, and Jab Hari Mat Sajal, Tube Light, these didn't even make the list, the other big releases of the year. Jagga Jasus obviously didn't make the list. So the way things are going, what it looks like is we're now losing ground in the global market. Hindi film no longer has a foothold in the global market. It's going backwards. There's the outliers, there's PK and Dangal, which are still at the top, but everything else is moving back. And the reason this is happening, I think, is because there's too much focus on this exact list that I just spent so long talking about. The problem is everybody wants to get in the top 10. Everybody's looking at that massive box office. Here's some other figures to look at. Tiger Zindahay, in opening weekend on over 300 screens in America on Christmas weekend, made less money than Don on many fewer screens years ago. That's a bad sign. People are losing interest. People don't want to show up opening weekend. And you can hide it by increasing your screen count and even increasing your ticket prices in some places. But it's still going to come out. And that's what we're seeing. For the past several years, there's been this push to get mediocre films into this top 10 list by pumping up their screen count and other artificial means. If you look at Sultan as a case sample, massive screen count, released on Eid, which was midweek that particular week, which gave them a little bit of extra time even on that opening weekend. Plus, huge publicity campaign. You could not turn around without seeing a poster or an ad for it. And there were the songs everywhere, and there were the interviews, and there was all of this stuff. And even to the point of Yash Raj arranged for Shahrukh's release, Race, not to come out on Eid. And there were some other movies that moved last minute so that it had the longest possible open run with no other competitors. And even so, it barely edged out how films were doing on a third as many screens with a third as much publicity years earlier. I don't think that it's that films are getting worse or audiences are getting less interested. I think it's that people are getting lazy. It's easy to take a mediocre film and throw money at it and get it on this list. What's hard is to find a good film and get people interested in watching it. There still are good movies coming out. There's a lot of good movies coming out. But they aren't able to find an audience because these big films are taking all of their screens. I'll give you an example. This year, I really loved two movies, A Gentleman and Shubh Mangal Savdan. They were both good, solid, small films. I don't think they were ever going to reach the top 10 list for the box office, but they could do a solid run and make a decent profit. However, unfortunately, they released at the same time as the movie Badshah Ho. And Badshah Ho was a slightly bigger film. It had Ajay Devgan starring in it, it had a bigger studio behind it, and so on and so forth. And so Badshah Ho took a ton of screens from these other two smaller films. Badshah Ho ended up having a terrible release. Made almost no money per screen, probably was a loss for the studio in the end. So sad for Badshah Ho, maybe they'll learn their lesson, whatever. But forget Badshah Ho for a second, look at its effect on the other films that were coming out. Because the studios decided to give this big push to this movie that ended up being not that great, that meant theaters had to throw out other decent small films to make space for the big stupid movie. And that's what's happening again and again and again. These big stupid films are getting tons of screens and tons of promotion and basically taking over all possible audience. And these smaller films don't have room to breathe anymore. So this top 10 list is no longer a reflection of things like Three Idiots, which are such high quality and so original and so different that they demand an audience response, but rather a reflection of things like, well, Dilwale, which is also on the list, things which just had such a huge promotion and such a huge release that they force an audience response that isn't there naturally. One final thing to think about. If you look at the record-breaking films for Hindi film through time, for the majority of Hindi film history, a box office record was held for at least 5 years, if not longer. Because that's the kind of movie that earned that box office. Box office was coming because people came back to see it over and over again, because it was so remarkable that it was literally a once-in-a-lifetime experience. And that would drive the box office up. Since Three Idiots, there's been this pattern of every big film is expected to be a record breaker. All of a sudden, you can't just accept that Three Idiots was the once-in-a-lifetime game-changing film and everything else should just try to be the best film it is and not beat that record. Suddenly, people are cheating, essentially, doing everything they can to break that record, to get on this list, or else somehow it doesn't count. Everybody's focused on breaking the box office record instead of on just sitting back and admiring the remarkable accomplishment of the last film to have set that landmark and seeing if artistically you might be able to achieve the same, not in terms of money. Anyway, that's how it looks to me. Now that Tiger Zinda Hai is ending its run, I hope we have seen the end limit of the mass release strategy for driving box office and might be moving back towards the actual high quality films and don't worry so much about the box office strategy. You can agree with me, you can disagree with me. There's a related post linked right below. Just hop over there and leave me a comment and I'll respond. Thanks. Bye.